guys, welcome back to my channel. It's Tia here. If you are new, please like and subscribe. For today's video, I'm going to be doing a quick Q&A video, just a couple of questions I had people ask me. So let's get into it. The first one is, who is your favorite rapper? Personally, I think Nicki Minaj is queen of rap. Obviously, like, you know, people came before her, but for this generation is Nicki Minaj. Can't really deny that. But I also do like Doja Cat a lot. I tend to memorize her songs really fast for some reason. Next one, how do I do my brows? I actually have an eyebrow tutorial on my channel. I might have to update it because I have found like a quicker way to do them. But I basically just use Anastasia Dip Brow. They look like this. I don't really take the time to like do them perfectly anymore. Like, my eyebrows are kind of full, so I'll just kind of like fill them in, and especially the ends, because I really don't have any eyebrows at the ends. And then I'll just take like a little bit of concealer and carve them out, but I'm not really so like pressed on making them like perfect anymore, like how obsessed I was to do them before. It would take me like forever. You want to have kids one day? Yes, I actually do. Like, I've always been obsessed with having a kid. It's like, obviously, like, I know not everyone is meant to have kids, and like, females are put on earth to make kids or whatever, but it's like, I don't know, I'm kind of torn on that. Like, I feel like I would be okay if I didn't, but I know part of me would be like low-key regret like not having any. I don't know why. And then I've always just wanted a daughter, like a little mini me to like dress up and take cute pictures with. But of course, like, you know, teenage years is gonna be horrible if she ends up like me. But overall, I feel like I would be a good mom. I have like a whole bunch of girl names. I'll put them on the screen. But yeah, I feel like boys are just like, I don't want any boys. If I turn into a boy mom, I'm gonna be so mad. Like, I'm not gonna throw a fit at the gender reveal, but I'm gonna be pissed off. When do you feel overwhelmed? Right now I am not working for reasons, but so I'm basically just overwhelmed, like wondering like what kind of job I should get. I don't know like what I was meant to do in this lifetime, so I'm like kind of figuring that out. It is kind of stressful when you don't know what to do. You know, there's all a whole bunch of people asking you like, what do you want to be when you grow up, blah blah blah, what are you trying to do? It's like, I'm trying to be happy. Like, literally, like, that's just the biggest thing, is like, I want to be happy. I want to be like making just a decent amount of money. Like, my goal isn't necessarily to end up like rich. I feel like this generation is so obsessed with like making money and being rich by like 20, like in their 20s. Like, I don't know, like, if it comes later, like, I wouldn't be mad if I ended up being a millionaire when I was like 30 or 40. Like, why does it have to be 20? But it's like, as long as I can take care of myself and my family, like, I wouldn't be mad. So it's like, overall, I'm just trying to be happy. But yeah, so a lot of stuff is just like kind of overwhelming, and then when I get overwhelmed, I end up stressing out, and then when I get stressed out, I get like these little bumps all over my face. But yeah, when are you getting your next tattoo? This one, I don't know, I want it to be sooner rather than later. I did find a tattoo artist who did like all of my tattoos so far, but at the same time, she's not like perfect, considering like she's only been doing this for 3 years, so she isn't really that experienced and stuff. But she does do good work. So she did give me a deal. I told her I liked the little sticker book design, how it's like a sleeve but not like a real complete sleeve. So I told her I like that kind of design. And she was like, oh, well, since you want to get a bunch of small ones, I'll do 3 for like $60. Because the shop minimum is $80 normally. But she was like, oh, I'll do like 3 little ones for $60. So I'm like, oh, wow, like, that's a good deal, you know? And, but now I'm like, do I want like to keep getting little ones, or do I want like actual quotes? Do I want like more drawings and everything? Overall, so expensive, but if I stay with her, she's gonna get me like a good deal. So they might be coming soon, whenever I can make an appointment with her, because she be booked up all the time. Pineapple on pizza? No. no, it should be illegal. Why are you putting fruit on pizza, sweet, savory? Like, I don't get people who like that. Like, when I think of pineapple, I think of like all the juices it has in it, and it's like, I don't want all that juice mixing with my sauce and the cheese. Like, and I just know I won't like it. That's why I won't try it, because I just know myself and I know I won't like it. We play video games. I wish I had a PS4 so I could get into like streaming and video games, because like, I don't know, like, I want to be like that kind of girl who like wears the headphones and actually likes playing. But I never played fighting games when I was growing up because they were like too violent and whatever. So I only played like the little Lego games that we had on Xbox. How do you cope with social anxiety? Me, I kind of just deal with it. Like, I have to like just suck it up. In all those like school presentations, I would just have to just suck it up whole time. I would be like holding my paper and shaking because I was having like a freaking anxiety attack. And it's like I always had to go to the bathroom before, because it's like nervous poop or whatever, I don't know. It's like I always have to go before, and then I'd be freaking out whole time. And then it's that one person that's like, I can't hear her or whatever, and the teacher purposely sits in the back and they'll be like, oh, you need to speak up. I'm like, what is the point of this? And then we also had like those speeches in English class where the Socratic seminar or whatever, where you sit in a circle and you have to discuss the book or whatever, and then everyone's required to speak like at least once or twice. But during that, I would like never talk. I would purposely sit there, and then the teacher, she would talk to me and be like, why didn't you talk, blah blah blah, you know this is part of your grade, right? And I'm like, you can't really, like, people have anxiety, like, I hate that. How was your experience in high school? I feel like overall I had like a decent experience. I wouldn't say it was super bad. It wasn't like super good. I wasn't popular or anything like that. I was a background character, you know. I was like the third friend, the fourth friend actually, who was like barely included in the pictures. I was always like in the corner, hanging off the sidewalk, stuff like that. And I think it was like literally my first day of high school. I sat and ate my lunch in the bathroom because I didn't have any friends during my lunch. But then like overall it got decently better as I started to know people and get a group. And then senior year was like, I say like that was like one of the best years. 2016, that was the last time I had like an actual good year. So overall the experience was pretty decent for me. I'm not one of those people that's like, oh, like I hate high school, I'll never go back there, you know, because these days it's like I would actually go back to high school. Like, I wouldn't mind being in high school like forever. Is better than being like an adult with real problems, real issues, real bills, in this confusing mindset. Like, how do you feel about having friends of the opposite sex? I mean, I feel like it's a good thing because then you have like different mindsets when you have questions about stuff, and they give like good advice sometimes. But it's hard to do that because I would be like, yeah, like I want guy friends who I can talk to, you know. But at the same time, it's like girls sometimes they be insecure about the guy's like female best friend, you know, because it's like I was the best friend at that point, you know. If a guy called me his best friend, it's like we would low-key do stuff together and stuff like that. So it's like that kind of messes it up for the ones who like don't do anything with their guy friends. But yeah, it's like it's hard to find a guy who just wants to be a friend, you know. They always end up wanting something more. Tips for taking pictures. I actually have a video on this, I think, too, from like a really long time ago. But I basically just have a tripod with a ring light on it, and then I basically just use that for all my pictures. I would say practice your posing in the mirror sometimes. Like, I know this side is my good side, so I take all my pictures like from this side, never this side, because I feel like my face is just uneven. So just know your good angles and your good sides. Also practice like posing. I tend to do the same poses like over and over in my pictures, which is low-key weird, but that's what works. And then also like check your makeup and hair before you take the pictures, and just wear a cute outfit and be confident. How many exes do I have? Two. I've had multiple guys I've talked to, but I don't consider them like boyfriends, you know, like I talked to a guy for a week and he was like clingy and he would be like, yeah, we're dating, but then it's like it didn't work out, so I don't consider him as an ex. My first boyfriend was for like a year and it was just toxic, and then the second one it was like 3 months I think, but it, like, I didn't take it seriously back then. So it's like I only had two exes, and I think some people say that's like a little bit. I've talked to guys who's like, yeah, I've had like 11 or whatever, like you're my 11th girlfriend. I'm like, doesn't that mean you're the problem if you've gone through like 11 girls and you can't stick with one? Who are your favorite singers? Rihanna has always been number one for me. But now I feel like it's more so Ariana Grande, just because she's actually putting out music. Rihanna. But yeah, it's Rihanna, Beyonce, Ariana. Then like the old people is like Alicia Keys, Neo, Usher. So that was it for the Q&A video. Hope that answered your questions. If you have any more questions, comment them down below, and I'll probably make like multiple videos to this. And thank you guys for watching. Stay tuned for more videos.